There's a lot happening in the fashion world, starting with Met Gala, and this year the theme was Scam, Notes on Fashion. We saw our very own B-Town celebrities attending the gala.
There were so many gorgeous looks and I loved so many of them. Love all the effort they put into styling and the outfits.
But Vani, that's not all we're talking about today. The other celebrities took inspiration from the gala and channelized the glam look in the outfits that they wore this week.
So today we're looking at some of the trending celebrity looks in this episode of
Crush or Crash. Okay, so first on the list is Malaika Arora, and she is wearing, she's wearing Yas Couture, Ellie Mabi, and Farah Khan World.
That's an army, Aparna.
I mean, you've heard that saying, they say too many cooks spoil the broth.
That's the case right here.
Khichdi.
Yep.
So basically she's wearing a off-shoulder gown which has a sweetheart neckline. This entire gown is in a metallic shade with balloon sleeves and it has that crunch detail. Like you see a lot of creases throughout the dress, pleats or whatever you call it. Mm-hmm. And then you have a belt. The belt also is creased.
Yeah, the texture.
Oh. It's clutter.
Yeah.
It's not pretty. It's not working as a texture. It's not a good design element. Mm-hmm. It's just clutter.
True.
I mean, I really like Malaika. Like, here. Love the earrings, love her makeup, smoky eyes, nude lips, hair looks amazing. She looks stunning, but neck below, everything's a disaster.
So first of all, there are too many elements in here which are obviously not going together. First is the color. That's a very strong color that you are trying to, you know, like make a statement with, which is okay. But then on top of that, you have like tons and tons of fabric. And then you have that texture happening, you know, the pleats and that crushed fabric and all of that on the belt and everything. So that's the second element. And then you have these all falls happening, okay? So you have this cold shoulder and balloon sleeve, uske saath free, which is, that's a really bad deal, I would say. It's looking so tacky.
Yeah.
But yeah, apart from the disaster, love that messy curls and like, wo dikh raha hai kitni mehnat lagi hai baalon mein. And love the makeup, smoky eyes, nude lips. You know, like she's got
she's
this beautiful...
She's looking smoking hot.
Yeah, exactly. And like those diamond and what is that?
Yeah, with the green emerald.
Yeah, oh my
beautiful.
God.
Beautiful.
Really, really beautiful and elegant. Seams are not done well.
Yeah.
And then she's wearing these almost the same color sandals, like
yeah,
strappy heels.
Which is fine.
Yeah, but really not into this look, Malaika. I'm sorry. We both are
crushing it.
Okay, so next on the list is Shilpa Shetty Kundra. Woohoo! Are you feeling it? I'm feeling it. Are you feeling it? I'm feeling it. So Shilpa Shetty is wearing this nude tone embellished and fringed gown by Yusuf Al-Jasmi. I want to talk about the color first. Beautiful color and looking really pretty on Shilpa Shetty. But that cold shoulder. That cold shoulder is making me cold. Like my heart is cold right now because it's looking hella ugly. I love the fit on her. You can't deny that she's got
absolutely
a beautiful body and you know the way it's hugging her, it's like beautiful. But there are so many things that I don't like. First of all, it's a beautiful piece, a beautiful color, but then you paired it up with that headband. Like that's like taking the theme too literally. I get it was a disco theme and you know, so she wore this for that the show. She is a
super
dancer and like Mithunda had come or something. Gown ticket beautiful hair, but then those peep toe Louboutins, I don't get it. I just hate it. And Upalna, aap makeup dekhiye aur mujhe bataiye aapko ye acha lag raha hai nahi lag raha, cuz mujhe to bilkul acha nahi lag raha. And wo lipstick to jo isne gulab se nikal ke color
isko rani pink kehte
hain. Rani pink color.
Sabse pehli cheez that bugs me is the length of the dress. Then the petal wrap is not working. It's just a weird cut. So it ends on a very weird place when you see her legs. But here the elements are retro, but nothing works together. Mm-hmm. Secondly, all the elements should, like I understand fringe was the retro idea, disco was the idea. So you went for the shimmer, the gold, the shine. The lengths odd, the cuts odd, the fits bad, that gold band is, I get it, you were trying to get the whole Mithunda face back, but why such pristine, clean, blow-dried hair with solitaire? Like, it's like Shilpa Shetty ko upar se photoshop karke upar dala hai. Why? look like a very blah look. With such a beautiful outfit, honestly, the gown, I really like the fabric and the color on her. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's just the other technical points for me, which is completely killing it. So we're killing it and we are crashing it. So now we have Deepika Padukone's look from Met Gala. The theme, the epic theme,
Cam.
She's wearing this gown by Zac Posen, and this is a lifted corset. It's a pink color gown with a lifted corset and multi-layered
structured skirt.
And you can see like subtle embellishments happening on the skirt, like behind. Like actually it's partially done from the front side, it's just the texture. And she styled this look with dramatic lips and eyes, purple eye makeup, burgundy lips, dark burgundy lips, and really voluminous ponytail, like high voluminous ponytail with that embellished headband, which is also pink, with earrings, which is also pink. First, I'll start with Vani's world. Wow, that's a lot of pink. That's a hell lot of pink. Firstly, I do not like the look. It's not dramatic. It's not inspirational. You know, Met Gala, there's a reason you get a theme. People want to see experiments. People want to see fashion. People want to see you walking around in installations if possible. Deepika, again, same thing. She tried, but still very much in her safe zone. The same pink color, the gown's the same, the corset gown with the multi-layered, multi-tier skirt. It's just like it's structured and more voluminous than what she generally goes for. Yeah. And the ponytail, of course, she tried, but it's not working for her. She's looking pretty, but there's nothing to the look. I feel like I missed the story. And Met Gala is all about creating a story on the carpet.
Yep. I love the gown. Like Zach, I'm a huge fan of Zach Posen. Like, love his creation. But, and this is looking beautiful, like the way it fits her, beautiful. But again, it's not according to the theme. And then the hair and makeup, she tried to go like a bit different.
But I just don't understand, the makeup's too dark and the hair is a very Barbie hair, but come on.
I don't know, it's like, I'm just honestly really confused too when I look at it, because yeah, it's pretty, but it's not what it's supposed to be.
Agreed.
So yeah, and for that reason, we both are
crashing it. Okay, so next is another Met Gala look, and this was PC, a Piggy Chops.
Piggy Chops.
And she wore this custom-made gown from Dior. It was particularly made for this event, and this look was styled by Mimi Cottrell, of course we know, her favorite stylist.
Yep.
So I know this look was actually criticized, like I think we got like a lot of mixed reviews about it. The first thing that comes to your mind is Queen, which is very, very evident. And I like the whole idea of the makeup on it. I think it was a touch of humor to it. Like,
definitely,
her makeup is extremely dramatic, like extremely dramatic. What I like about this look is, this is not something that you will just see and forget.
Of course.
Which is brilliant.
Brilliant.
That's what Met Gala is all about.
Yeah.
It's a semi-shirt, caged corset.
Torso
gown with again those stockings, which are sheer stockings with embellishment on it, and then I think there is a wrap, a skirt and then you
feather.
Have this feathers, and then you have this huge cape, again multicolored feather detail, which is yellow, then goes to gray, fuchsia pink, to burgundy. You can see the ombre happening, so that's interesting. I think the only thing that shocked everyone was the makeup. It's animated, it's very funny. It has a funny take on the whole look. The afro hair, the crown, everything kind of works. But the makeup, the only thing that I thought was adorable was the bindi.
I'm not a big fan of the entire outfit. It's Dior, it's okay. But like, there are too many elements happening. You have the cage thing happening and you have these hand-cut feathers. That's interesting, but that's a bit too much. Makeup is on point. I love the white waterlined eyes and the, you know, exaggerated eyelashes, the lipstick, the, you know, really strong blush, and the hair. That back comb hair is just giving me life right now. And that custom made Dior crown just sitting so nicely on that nest of a hair. Really beautiful. Certain elements which I liked were the stockings.
Love them. Even the cage bodice.
Yeah, it's interesting, but I'm not a fan of the feather detail.
The skirt, baby.
And also the fact that the look is majorly overstyled, like meaning or way, or I don't know, the earrings and the, you know, super choking torso and the cape bhi, baal bhi, it's too much. Like, main kahan kahan concentrate karun? Like, anyway, like the centerpiece, like the masterpiece is this creation right here. But yeah, PC, love you and love you for the effort and thanks for making India proud.
So we both are crushing this look.
The next on the list is again PC in that beautiful, beautiful Dior
romper.
I love every damn thing about this look, from the hair to the makeup to the dress to the sheer leggings to the heels. Everything is on point. So I'm gonna start with a romper. Oh my god, what a masterpiece. This version of a romper is just a surprise. And I love the whole embellishment and the, you know, how like the color is traveling, it's making a pattern and everything. Love those poofed sleeves and, you know, they have some poofiness around the thighs also. Oh my god, beautiful. And if you'll notice, she's wearing the same leggings that she wore during the day with her exaggerated outfit and with the same pumps again that she was wearing in the day. So yeah, wo to hume pasand aaya hi tha pehle bhi, so love that. And if you'll notice that the makeup and the hair is completely different. Like the makeup is still loud, but it's completely different. Like the, yeah. Now the waterline is blue and you have like pink and, you know,
you
gray.
See the under eye, there's a lot of white smokiness, yeah. Under eye, which kind of is very weird that it's actually working.
This is such a drag glam look and I love the hair, love the makeup, love the romper and yeah, everything. Oh my god, I'm just obsessed. And this was an after party look that I was drooling over.
They look epic. She is looking stunning. It doesn't even look like she was like out since morning or whatever she's been attending a evening long event. I like how she's kept her hair. It's super retro. I really like that. Coming back to the romper. Definitely a masterpiece. I love it. I can never imagine a romper being something as stunning and as beautiful as this. Love the choice of color. The white on a tan skin is, I think, the most gorgeous combination.
Match made in heaven.
Match made in heaven, agreed. Love the precision. You can see the detail. Oh my god, you will, when you see the patterns happening, it's actually the way the sequin has been placed on it. That's what couture is all about.
Yep.
And I'm sure it was hand done. Imagine how much time this garment must have taken. So you can see the whole movement, which is beautiful. Now I think this is, when I say monotone, like go all same color, this is how you do it.
Yep.
With the break of nice silver, blue embellishment, sequin. She's also wearing earrings, which is not making it look over. I don't know how. I've spoken a lot. I think I'm just going to get, like I've gotten a verbal diarrhea. So all in all, this look is super, super hot and we both are like drooling over it, crushing it.
Okay, so last on the list is Sonam Kapoor Ahuja and she's wearing this beautiful pastel pink and green and peach tone Anarkali by Anamika Khanna. I love the outfit. The color palette is just so soothing and I think this is the appropriate, like the perfect outfit for a haldi ceremony because, you know, it's hot, it's summer and you need that palette that you can like sort of feel cool and not like those maroons and burgundies, like the the typical Indian colors. I love the anarkali, I love the length of it. So like it's a full length anarkali and, you know, again the way she's carrying the dupatta over her shoulders, like a very royal feel.
It gives her a cape look, like a jacket look.
Yeah. It's because like the inside wala anarkali is sort of plain. Hmm. The embroidered dupatta is sort of adding that jacket effect. So that's obviously beautiful. And how can we miss out on that beautiful jewelry by her mom?
I was just about to
say. Mommy, you're rocking it. And the daughter is also rocking it. And I love the hair, like how she kept that chic bun because you have a lot of jewelry happening. So you want that space, you know, and also she has a tiny face. And love the dewy makeup, like perfect for a day event. So all in all, it's just admirable look. So yeah, I love it.
She does look very dreamy in this look. It is because of the colors. Kudos to Anamika Khanna for this piece. I'm very used to seeing whites when it comes to Anamika Khanna designs, but here she's chosen colors, but again, keeping her design elements and her features in intact. When I see this look, it's so beautiful. The colors are soft and pleasant. And in the summer heat, I want to feel that coolness. It's just so refreshing. Love the choice of the colors. I like the idea of keeping yellow and the pink, the pastels, muted and plain underneath that dupatta, which is slightly heavy. But the color again is very soft and very light. I love how every element is the hero. And the makeup's nice, it's soft and dewy, the hair is in a clean bun. So if you see, every element just ties up together. And Sonam, as usual, is acing it, wearing it with utmost poise. Yeah, utmost poise and elegance you can talk about. So we both are crushing it. Let us know which looks worked for you and which didn't in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed watching this video, then please do like it.
And don't forget to check out the POPxo shop. We've got some really cool new products like backpacks and fanny packs and doormats and whatnot. So just click on the link in the description box and go shop now.
And for more fashion tips, hacks, hauls and news on celebrity looks, keep watching POPxo Daily.